weird. You're a good chef. Did you steal it from Donald? Oh my goodness. Yeah. He's sitting. He never sits with me. It's Chip and Dale.
That's right.
His name is Dale. Hello, hello, yes. So cute, yay. Oh my goodness, who is that? Oh, look at Farmer Mickey. I love his dice.
I know.
You're so funny. I want you to meet Dale.
My name's Dale. Yeah, working hard.
Of all the forces at work on the land, humans have had one of the most profound effects: the need to produce food for a growing world.
Cheese. Hi, Goop. Hi, Mickey. How are you?
Thank you. Thank you. Sajak.
Thank you very much. Well, Merry Christmas, everybody. If you've been watching Wheel of Fortune at all in the last week or so, you may have noticed I'm not there. Had a little bit of a health issue a few weeks ago. I had to have emergency surgery, but I'm happy to announce everything is just fine. I believe I hear my doctors applauding. It was just a fluke, frankly, and doctors say I will be as good as new. I can sing, dance, play the piano, all things I couldn't do before surgery. So I was replaced by Vanna, Mickey, and Minnie, and Vanna did a great job, and I'm so grateful to her to step in the way she did. It turns out she really likes hosting. I'm not worried, but I'll put it this way. We were taping the other day. I'm back in the studio at work, and our dressing rooms are above the stage, so we have to walk downstairs to get to the stage. And we usually walk down together. I don't really think she'd do anything, but just as a precaution, I didn't walk in front of her, just in case there was a little, oh, I'm hosting again. She also brought in some homemade cupcakes. I had someone taste them before I ate mine. Just, again, precaution. It was a frightening experience, especially for my family. So this is a blessed Christmas for us, and this candlelight processional, a very meaningful one for us as well. So I hope you can look into your lives and see your blessings, and hope you feel the same way about this season. So right now, just sit back and relax. We're going to tell you a story that's been told for over 2,000 years. It's been a tradition at Disneyland, now Disney World, for over 60 years. It's a story of love and peace and hope. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin who was betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. Where is he who has been born King of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose in the east and have come to worship him." And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
Thank you.
As we each treasure our unique holiday traditions of family, faith, and culture, let us join together in celebrating the birth of the blessed babe in a manger and rejoice in the universal message of peace on earth and goodwill toward men. Joy to the world.
Joy to the world.
Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And our thanks to a man who has proven that you can wear your high school prom tux and still look great, the maestro, Jeffrey Redden. And by the way, how about the fine signing done down there? That was really great. I mean, for all I know, she could have been doing the Orlando phone book, but she looked really great. Mostly thanks to you, and wish you a blessed Christmas and a happy and very healthy New Year. Thank you, folks. Good night.
While there are more than 50,000 edible plant species in the world, most of us are only familiar with the handful that make up our everyday diet. The common grains growing here, wheat, maize, sorghum, and millet, plus rice, account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world. Some of the answers are being discovered just ahead. To help us maintain these carefully controlled ecosystems, and for your safety, please remain seated in your boat at all times. Welcome to our living laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce bountiful harvests now and into the future. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. When we mention farming, you probably don't think of fish. But fish farming, or aquaculture, accounts for nearly half of all the seafood consumed globally. Tilapia, bass, and catfish, like the ones you see here, are three of the more popular crops raised by fish farmers. The sustainable system we're using here recycles the water in the tanks. As a result, we're able to save millions of gallons each year. By populating our greenhouses with beneficial insects that prey on harmful pests, like aphids and flies, we are significantly reducing our reliance on conventional pesticides. We're growing these crops using our nutrient film system. This technique precisely controls and recycles water and nutrients. With it, we can produce over 27,000 heads of lettuce a year in this one small area. Some of our best ideas have been inspired by nature, like these fruit and vegetable trees. By growing these ground plants vertically, we can increase yields and better control diseases. These crops taste as good as they look. In fact, we serve more than 15 tons of produce from our greenhouses in restaurants here at the land every year. These greenhouses represent just a fraction of the work being done worldwide to produce bountiful harvests for our growing population.